Hello students, as we have read about the discovery of the gases which was given by Lavoisier and Priestley in the last class, which come under the chapter respiration. Today we will read about experiments done by Lavoisier. As we know that Lavoisier has done many experiments, from that we are going to study two experiments now. Okay. In this experiment, it was done to find that CO2 is liberated out or not. Actually, we human beings take in oxygen and liberate out or expel out carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide is absorbed by the plants for the purpose of photosynthesis. So let's see what he is doing in this experiment. In his experiments, he has took a water truck. He used a bell jar. He has heated charcoal. He put some charcoal for the water tub was filled with water. Water truck. This is bell jar. This is powdered charcoal. So he started to heat it by the help of a spirit lamp or a Bunsen burner. This is a Bunsen burner. He started to heat this powdered charcoal. When it started to heat, he has observed some gases liberating out from this charcoal. And he named it fixed air. Fixed air. In present time, we call it as carbon dioxide gas. We call it as carbon dioxide gas, but that time it was known as fixed air. In fixed air, so this experiment showed that when we burn powdered charcoal, when we burn charcoal, a gas is liberated out, which is used by the plants for the purpose of photosynthesis, not by the animals. And this gas was carbon dioxide or fixed air. So what we have done? Lavoisier has took a water trough. He has poured some water in that. He has covered. He has again he took a stand, and in which he kept some powdered charcoal. He covered it with a bell jar, and he started to heat this powdered charcoal. Then a gas was liberated out that was known as fixed air or carbon dioxide. In this, here we took powdered charcoal. But in the another experiment again he did, in which instead of taking powdered charcoal, he took phosphorus. So again Lavoisier has done another experiment, but instead of powdered charcoal he used phosphorus. The same experiment was repeated. There was a water trough. The trough was filled with water. He has kept a stand in which he put some phosphorus, and he has covered it with a bell jar. Again he started to heat it. Again I am repeating this. In the first experiment, he has took a water trough. He has put a stand. In the stand, it was phosphorus, and he has put water in the trough and covered with the bale jar. And he started to heat it. What he has noticed? In the first experiment, some gases liberated out. The gas was fixed here. In nowadays, it is carbon dioxide gas. But in the second experiment, when he started to heat phosphorus, it started to burn. What happened here? It started to burn. Burning means combustion took place here. Combustion. Here, combustion takes place. Combustion is a process which takes place in the presence of oxygen. We know these things. It was, he noticed that it was not water vapor. It was not water vapor. It was not due to water vapor. There was some gas which helped in combustion. In the first experiment, we found that when we heated powdered charcoal, carbon dioxide was released. But in the second experiment, when we heated phosphorus, it started to burn. When it burned, that means there is some gas which helps in combustion. And if people know, there are a few gases which helps in combustion. Example is oxygen also. So this was the experiments. This was the experiments done by Lavoisier. So again, Lavoisier has done many experiments, in which two we have already discussed. In the next experiment, what he did, he has took a metal and he burnt it. He burned it. Then he found that, he noticed that a gas is liberated out, which is known as fixed air, Nowadays, carbon dioxide. Earlier, the people, in those days, the people were not knowing about carbon dioxide. They knew about fixed air. In the same way, when we breathe in, which gas we take? Breathe in. We take oxygen. Those days, people were not knowing about oxygen. They were knowing that it is respirable air. Respirable air or gas. They don't know about oxygen. So here he noticed a difference that when he burnt a metal, fixed air or carbon dioxide gas is released out. When we take in air, we take oxygen or respirable air. Then again he has given some differences. When he burnt metal, a gas, fixed air or carbon dioxide was released. Then what he did, he took a test tube in which he put lime water. What he put? He has put lime water. Another, what he did, when we breathe out, again one gas is released from our body, that was again carbon dioxide. Again he took one test tube, he put some lime water in this also. And he passed this gas in this lime water. He noticed that the lime water turns milky. Lime water turns milky here. This shows that when we burn anything, when we burn metal, a gas is released out, which is carbon dioxide. And when we expelled out, when we breathe out, again one gas is released out, that is carbon dioxide. That means both the gases are same. And to note this, to observe this, he has took lime water in which he passed the gas. when he passed the gas, he has seen that carbon, that lime water when passing through this carbon dioxide gas, it turns into milk. The color changes like milk water, like milk. So this experiment, this observation, he noted that a human being or animals, when breathe out, they releases fixed air, and when we burn anything, then also we release fixed air. This was the observation done by Lavoisier. These experiments shows that we take in oxygen, we release out carbon dioxide. Now we'll discuss about the pathway of air. Nasal cavity, these are the organs which involve the pathway of air. Nasal cavity, nostrils, larynx, alveoli, trachea, epiglottis, pharynx, bronchi, bronchiolus, lungs. These are the organs which are involved in the pathway of air. Here one thing I would like to say is that our left, we have a pair of lungs. One in both the sides. The left lungs is little smaller than the right one. Why? You can ask a question, ma'am, why? So let me say this. Actually, our heart is placed in the middle of both the lungs, but the aorta of the heart is tilted left side. That's why the left lungs is little compressed. And these lungs and heart is situated in a dome shaped structure that is called diaphragm. This is a dome shaped structure. So you can ask, madam, dome means hemisphere. Dome shaped structure means hemisphere, like a half sphere. This is the heart. So what happens in this pathway? These two chamber which you see in your nose is called the nostrils, and the chamber through the nose inside, it is called nasal chamber or nasal cavity. What happens in nose, we have fine, small tiny hairs and mucous membrane. Mucus is present in our nasal cavity which traps the harmful microorganisms and dust particles to enter in our lungs. It will trap it here only, and the fresh air will go inside. Through the nasal cavity, the air goes in the trachea region. The trachea region, if you touch your neck region here, you can feel it. It is D-shaped structure present in front of the esophagus. The back side is the food pipe and front side is the windpipe, or known as trachea. Trachea is also known as windpipe. Then is the epiglottis, pharynx. Pharynx is a common pathway for both the air, water and food. When we eat anything, this it is a common pathway for both the air and water. Epiglottis is a flap-like cover. It helps in the entry of prevention. This is a part which helps to prevent the entry of food particles into the trachea. Whenever we eat anything, the food goes in the stomach through the esophagus. That time, with the help of the epiglottis, this trachea is covered. Pharynx is the common pathway for both the air and water. This larynx is called voice box. Due to vibration, sound is produced. I am speaking. People can hear me. How? Actually, in my larynx, some vibrations are going on. due to which I am able to speak. Then comes the bronchi. Then comes the bronchus. These are the part which from here, these are the part which enters into the lungs. Again, it is divided. Further, it is divided into air sacs. Bronchi, then bronchus. This main part is the bronchi. This part is the bronchi. Again, further it is divided. This is the bronchi. This is the bronchus, and this is the air sac. Okay. So this is the pathway. Air enters into our nostrils, nasal chamber, through here, through the help of the trachea. It goes into both the lungs. In the lungs, it is stored in a balloon-like structure that is called air sac. And now the oxygen is stored in the air sac. Now it will mix with our blood, mix with our hemoglobin, and mix the hemoglobin, oxyhemoglobin, mix the blood oxyhemoglobin, and it will transfer to the cells and tissues and to the different parts of the body, and it will carry oxygen. Thank you. Till today, this much only.